Hi, I'm Steve Dorn, and welcome to Trail Boss. Today we wanted to talk to you a little bit about another primitive hunting survival skill, and that's hunting with a spear. And I'm going to be perfectly honest with you, I've never done it, but I've seen it done by tribesmen around the world, and I've also seen some people here in the U.S. do it pretty effectively. So I'm going to show you what I've learned by observing them. I don't own a spear, but I do own a cold steel Bushman, which actually doubles as a spear. Basically what it is it's a hollow-handled knife, and you can fit it over the top of any stick and use it in a spear, or like on the short stick here, you can use it sort of as a machete or a chopping device. And the blade secures very easily to whatever stick you decide to put it on. For anybody interested in a good field knife, you really can't do much better than a Bushman. It's inexpensive, it's high quality, it's extremely sharp, and I'm really impressed with it. And that's pretty hard to do because I've been exposed to some of the finest blades in the country, actually around the world. And I'm telling you, for the money, you're not gonna do better than a Bushman, and it's a very versatile tool. If you choose not to use it as a spear, you can make yourself a little end cap and actually stick some survival supplies right there in the handle. There are several ways to use a spear. Probably the most recognizable are when you see tribesmen and they're running across the plains of Africa, and there are several of them, and they're chasing down a water buffalo, and they take their spear and they throw it at 20 or 30 yards and pin the animal to the ground. Well, when you're alone in the wilderness, that scenario doesn't work really well for a couple of reasons. One is that when you've got a bunch of tribesmen, what they do is they separate that animal from the herd. And when that animal realizes that it's separated from the herd, it usually stops in an effort to try to figure out a way to get back to the herd, and that's when they let the animal have it with the spears. In your case, being an individual, even if you were able to do that, to run and chase the herd, more than likely, you're not going to be able to cut one out by yourself. You need numerous participants to do that. And what we're going to do is show you how to use this in the most practical way possible when you're by yourself. What tribesmen or bushmen will do when they use a short spear like this is they'll actually use it when provoking an animal, such as a javelina or a wild boar. And when the animal either stops to defend itself or comes at them, they'll literally take the spear and they'll jam it into a vital location, killing the animal quickly. Unless you're starving to death, it's not one that I would recommend. And the reason for that is animals like wild boars and animals like javelina, it only takes them a matter of seconds to ruin your day. They will literally slice you from stem to stern without even thinking about it. So unless I was starving to death or put in a position where I absolutely had to take that animal, it's not the way I plan to do it. Things I would highly recommend to you, these things are very, very dangerous, not only to the game that you're going after, but to you. And it's real easy. You know, your mom talked about not running around with scissors because somebody's going to lose an eye. You'll lose an eye way faster with this thing than you would running around with scissors. So what I recommend to you, until you get to your hunting spot or until you're ready to hunt with this thing, that you keep it encased. And you just put some type of thing over the blade so that if you do fall or trip or whatever, you're not going to get cut or stabbed with your own spear. One of the safest and most recommended way to hunt with a spear is in this situation here where I'm up in a tree. The game animal comes beneath me as it's moving down the game trail. And what I do at that point is I don't throw the spear. I take the spear and I jam it into the vital organs of the animal to dispatch it quickly. The other way I've seen it done is that the hunter gets right on the game trail with his spear. We have a javelina game trail that comes right through here, and what we've done is we've cut some brush to force him to stay on this trail. He can't turn to the right or the left once he commits to go past this tree. What the hunter does is they stand next to the tree and they camouflage themselves much better than I'm camouflaged here, but we're just doing this for demonstration purposes. And when that animal comes through, they dispatch it, not by throwing the spear, but by jamming the spear as deep into its vital organs as they can. They typically let go of the spear. The animal will drag the spear off a little ways and typically lay down and die. However, they do keep some other type of tool, whether it's a sharp stick, a knife, or a short spear in their other hand, should that animal decide to turn on them. A lot of you are probably wondering if you need something like the Bushman to kill an animal, or you need an actual metal-headed spear. You really don't. You could do it just by sharpening the end of a stick, possibly heating it up to harden it in a fire. However, with the addition of the Bushman or some type of metal tip, the kill is going to be quicker and cleaner, and it's going to make your job a whole lot easier. Well, that's about it. Basically, there's only two ways to hunt animals with a spear. One is either to throw it and hit them, or the other one is to jam it into them. It's not rocket science. Anybody can do it. It's not something, like I said, I've done personally, but it's something that I might try in the future just to see how effective it would be in a survival situation. And stay tuned for future episodes. You may see me being chased around by a wild boar, javelina, who knows, maybe even a black bear as I try to stab it with a spear.
As always, be safe by being prepared. God willing, we'll see you on the trail. Please join us at Shiloh TV for news, articles, equipment tests, videos, tips, and much, much more.
One of the best ways to hunt the elusive producer type animal is to throw this thing as hard as you can toward their heart. That is, as if you can find a heart, because there's a consensus that they don't have one. But anyway, you throw this thing at them as hard as you possibly can, then you run like heck in the other direction, and hopefully they'll bleed out before they get to you. And it looks something like this.